So you're thinking of moving to Richmond, Virginia? In this video, we're gonna give you the 7 reasons why you should not move to this city. So stay tuned. Hi guys, I'm Rachel Allegra. I work for the Yateman Group, a long and foster team. We're number one in Richmond and we're number one in Virginia. We get calls, texts, emails every day from people just like you looking to make their move to Richmond, and I am so excited to help you guys. So hit the like and subscribe buttons below, leave a comment, and feel free to text me or call me with any of your real estate needs. Let's get into the video. Number one, public transportation. Public transportation is pretty weak here. There are trains that go in and out of the city and a train station right inside the city, but there is no subway or metro within the city. The city isn't big enough for it. There's a bus system that runs throughout the city, and the plus side to this is that the traffic is always pretty light. Since the city is pretty small, most people drive or walk. And the fact that it is not a major city, you don't spend a lot of time in traffic. Most places take you about 20 to 30 minutes to get to on average. You're not stuck in traffic like most major metropolitan cities like DC, New York, Chicago, etc. Number two, cold winters. Even though Richmond is considered the South, we have some very cold winters. It's not going to get as cold as Boston or New York, but you might get some snow and some freezing conditions. So you will want to make sure you prepare thoroughly for changing conditions and colder temperatures. Make a point to take precautions in having an adequate amount of gas in your car and winterizing your boat if you have one. Not to mention having your HVAC serviced regularly, along with making sure you have your water spigots turned off outside so they don't burst in freezing conditions. That would not be good. The best thing about this city is that you get all 4 seasons though, which leads me to my next point. Number 3, pollen. During spring, people who have seasonal allergies will likely have a flare-up during this time of the year because after winter, everything melts and it gets warmer. Pollen releases from the flowers and trees when everything starts blooming. The pollen is so prominent in the areas because of the wide diversity of trees and plants that grow here in this region. Richmond is definitely notorious for being one of the most problematic areas for pollen-related allergies and got in the top 10 most challenging cities in the country for seasonal allergies according to an asthma and allergy study in 2002. If you wind up moving here, visit your doctor first about how to prepare for allergy season if you're someone who is a bit more sensitive to seasonal allergies and pollen. Number 4, no major sports teams. Richmond has no major sports teams, but we have 3 major colleges nearby. VCU is the biggest one, which has an awesome basketball team. They even made it to the Final Four 1 year. There are also a minor league sports teams such as the Flying Squirrels, which are the baseball team in the area. Unfortunately, officials do not want the city to get too big, so no major sports teams will be brought to Richmond. But fortunately, you can travel up to DC for DC United Soccer, the Wizards and the Nats, and then if you want to travel south, you've got all the Carolina teams right there. Number 5 is limited nightlife. Richmond is a very chill, hipster city. Most people don't dress up in heels and go out clubbing like you would see in New York, Chicago, Miami, or DC. The nightlife is a little more of like a Vans and sneakers type vibe, lots of rooftop bars and breweries with outdoor live music. So if you're looking for a more chill vibe, but still a good time, this is definitely your place. And if you're looking for a city to go clubbing in, one of the major metropolitan cities would probably be a better fit for you. Number 6, scarce housing market. The Richmond area continues to be a hot market, just like most places in the US. There's so much opportunity here. Forbes ranked Richmond number 55 in the country, being one of the best places to find your career and start your business. Richmond, Henrico, and Chesterfield have been increasingly difficult to buy in for the working class folks. Low inventory with rising interest rates and competition have made home buying difficult, especially for first-time home buyers or people with not a lot of cash in their pockets. But don't worry, I am still here to help, and trust me, I will go to bat for you and make it my goal to get you into a house. Number 7, expensive private schools. If you don't want to send your kids to public schools in the city, then be prepared to spend a pretty penny on the private schools in Richmond. The average national price to send your child to a private institution is around $12,000, and Richmond is ranked well over that. There are popular private schools right outside of the city in the West End that cost over 25 grand each year for the K-5 school and over 29,000 for the adjacent high school. But not for nothing, the public schools outside of the city in the suburbs of Midlothian and Short Pump both have award-winning blue ribbon schools. So make sure you go to niche.com to check those out. Here's the conclusion, guys. Thank you for watching today. Make sure you like and subscribe below. And I hope you guys have a great day and contact me as your realtor.